All right, everybody, welcome and good evening to CFA's quarterly town hall, December edition. Got a lot of really good updates from the team on construction that's going on the base and some of the programs that are taking place here. Please remember, if there are any questions that you'd like to have answered, or if you're just, you know, you have something that you want to talk about, we are always available. Cup of Joe with the CO, out in Mankato, and breaking the ice seemed to be really good. One more thing I'd like to just kind of remind everybody is sponsorship on demand is really making a difference in answering questions and getting it right the first time. So please, everybody, just continue to engage and we'll continue to get all your questions answered in a timely manner. All that being said, let's kick it off with our public works officer, Tyler Sherrup.
Good evening. I'd like to discuss tonight some of our ongoing projects and initiatives. So there's active construction, contract paving different areas of the base. Some of the upcoming ones that are in high-vis areas is Forestall Street by the Blue Ridge, San Diego Street by PSD and the hospital. And then you see a map there of the Command Hill areas, lots of tenants. So that's phased work. We're currently in phase one, and we'll move throughout the next couple months on Command Hill. We're also excited to announce there's a $500,000 contract that's been awarded to expand and improve the NEX run dog kennel. That's located back by the fire department on main base and the wastewater treatment plant. So the contract's awarded, the contract will mobilize just after the holidays, and the work will happen in the slow part of the year, and we'll finish it before the peak of summer when PCS season is in its heaviest demand. What that scope is providing is a new toilet facility, a new room for cats being kept overnight. Three large dog kennels are being built, and then the backyard that's currently not used will become a turf dog run. In the area that's sometimes called McDonald's Playground, that playground was provided by the Officer Spouse Association in 2003. It was tagged out a couple years ago due to safety concerns and age. So we have a plan now to revitalize that area. We're gonna expand Cassano Park. The bottom right there shows a concept drawing of what it could become a public square to be used for families and lunch, but also award ceremonies and public base events. We look forward to finishing that design and then moving to expand Cassano Park. Finally, we're heavily involved with several stakeholders on the base that operate playgrounds. I want to give you an overview. We have over 30 playgrounds on main base and almost a dozen on Ikego. Family Housing operates 21 playgrounds all around the housing area. Often talked about the Duncan Street playground there at the top. So it degraded due to age and salt water. There is a plan to replace it with a playground that's currently being designed and planned. MWR also operates the playgrounds in the youth centers, as well as the two Berkey Field playgrounds, also known as the Seaside Parks. Those two parks had some safety concerns that were identified. They were taken offline and repairs are in progress. We'll reopen those on 16 December. Dodea operates playgrounds near its schools, inside the schools, and then also Navy Lodge has an old playground that's behind the facility. They've asked that to be converted to a gazebo. They believe their customers use the tower playgrounds across the street from Navy Lodge. With that, I'll turn it over to N9. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Larry Cronner, and I'd like to tell you all the great things that are going on with N9. We'll start with N9-1, which is Fleet Activities. Now, letters for Santa. If you or your children ever want to write a letter to Santa, we have a number of events where you can write a letter to Santa, drop it off with the team. The team will see to it that Santa gets this letter, and Santa replies to your letter. So this is important. It's important for your children. It's important for you, your holiday spirit. So we're all about it. As the whole mission of Fleet and Family is to make you, your team, better people. They do this by teaching you how to manage your stress, how to manage your money, how to make yourself more marketable, how to get along, anger management, preventing burnout. All of these things you can get training on how to help make you better through Fleet and Family. At Ikego, ESL, offering classes. If you're If English is a second language for you, this is a good chance for you to improve your English by watching classic films, working with the team there. And then we also have the sushi and the dormitory. New Year's events, health as well. This is a focus not only on how to build your money, but build your health. Healthier person, taking, this is part of the total we want to make you better process. Teen dating, violence awareness month, February, important. There'll be a lot more information coming up with that. MWR, lots of stuff going on with MWR. So we have a Jingle Bell Run 5K. That's coming up on the 8th of December. Breakfast with Santa at Ikego. Still have room for you there. Huge holiday concert, 7th Fleet Band at the Benny Decker on the 10th. Festival of Trees on the 9th and 10th. Decorations started yesterday and they look awesome. So we're ready for everyone to start going in tomorrow and start decorating their trees. Army-Navy game at the Oak Club, Swim with Santa, Ship Holiday Lights Contest. Come out, vote for your favorite decorations. There is going to be bicycle decorating, judging. There will be music. This is a good time. This is another opportunity to come together as a community and celebrate the holidays. We also have holiday buffets at all the clubs on the base, except for Elijah. The Liberty Center has an event going on for the single sailors almost every day. Now, coming up to the new year, we have celebrations for the new year. We have buffets going on for New Year's. We have events going on at the Alliance Club, at the O Club. We have family bowling to bring in the new year with your family. And all of this you can find in the Ahoy magazine. And 9-3 for housing. Christmas decorations allow 30 days before Christmas and 15 days after New Year's. The non-smoking policy, this is a major change, but as of 2 December, smoking is no longer allowed in housing, period. We had a situation, it was phased in, some people were grandfathered, that's no longer the case. And for the holiday season, limited housing services available from the 29th to the 30th. And with that, I'll turn it over to security.
Good evening, folks. I'm Ensign Hunt, the Assistant Security Officer for CPA. A couple of our ongoing areas of focus are school traffic enforcement, ensuring people are dropping off their children in appropriate areas, enforcing safe speed for the safety of the children, and increasing patrols in family housing areas. Our future areas of focus, long-term parking. Limited parking available on the installation, so please encourage people to park in legal parking spaces and report any violators.
Good evening, everyone. Mike May, Emergency Management. So just your year-end reminder about your emergency evacuation packets, or EEP, also known as NEO, if you hear that term. Really what I'm asking you to do is just, if you've already filled out these forms, just go and review them, make sure they're up to date. If you have not filled out these forms, or have not seen these forms, you can find them on our emergency management website. You can download them and fill them out. Really the important pieces of this, the NEO data card and a map to your residence are the two pieces of information that need to be turned into your EEP coordinator for your command. If you don't know who that is, please reach out to your command and find out. If they don't know, please reach out to me and we'll get it figured out. However, this is a standardized form. It's standard throughout USFJ, so the packet doesn't change between bases. It's the exact same. Again, just asking for you to go in, update these forms in the event that we do need to evacuate. It is for all non-military SOFA members. That was for two jobs.
Hey, good evening. My name is Chaplain Dave Camp from the Chapel of Hope, and we'd like to wish you a happy holidays from the chapel. Obviously, a very busy time for us. A lot of religious observances are taking place over the next month, starting with Hanukkah that starts this Thursday evening. So our Jewish community will be lighting their menorah in front of the chapel at 16:15 each evening. On Saturday evening, it will be at 17:15. So if you would like to celebrate with them, they invite you to come join them. Our full holiday schedule is up there on the left, but it's also available on our Facebook site. And we will also like to highlight that we will be having a Protestant Christmas Eve service on Ikego this year at the elementary school as well. Our angel tree, which we hold up every year, it's in our lobby of our chapel, but the QR code allows you to link up with potential children for our angel tree. That's available on our Facebook site as well. It benefits children from the Shirakaba orphanage out in town. So again, please check us out, and we'll have a wide range of different services available through Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, the day after Christmas for our Orthodox Christian community, as well as several vigils that will be taking place on New Year's Eve as well. So come check us out on Facebook and at the Chapel of Hope. Love to see you there.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Lieutenant Taylor from the Ikego Detachment. A couple updates from us. So first things first, please make sure you stay connected with the Ikego Liaison Office. We are on Facebook as well as through Gmail. So if you email us, you'll get our weekly newsletters as well as any other updates that we push out to the community. So there will be 10 additional parking spots that will be secured in the Club T and the next parking lot. It's for critical work that's required for the new CDC site, so we just ask for your continued patience and understanding as we get through that construction so that we can get further along with our construction projects for the new CDC. Also, for those that have driven through Ikego, we've implemented a four-way stop near Yasakigyado Street, near Issei Heights and the fire station. We are working to get the speed zone sign up there, so we just want to ensure continued safety for all residents that pass through those walkways. So please continue to exercise caution and safety as you transit through that four-way stop. Some other reminders for parking enforcement: please do not park outside of the orange cones outside of the gate at Ikego. We ask that you come inside the gate and park along the main road there, and then walk and pick up your packages, take your children to their bus stop, whatever the case is. We want to make sure we keep that lane clear, as well as ensuring that your children abide by traffic safety rules for walking their bicycles across the crosswalks, wearing their helmets, and just keeping a vigilant eye out for pedestrian traffic. But I am happy to announce that we've rescheduled our farmers market that was canceled last month due to inclement weather. So we're scheduling it for December 15th from 10 to 1500. Please come out and support. We'll have about 8 or 9 different vendors, but a lot of great stuff for the community. And we hope to see you there. And then lastly, as Aseko mentioned about the drop-off zones for school zones, please adhere to the posted times for Ikego Elementary School to make sure our children can get dropped off and picked up from school safely. Thank you. Okay, now we're on to the questions.
All right. Good evening. My name is Randall Baldwin. I'm the Installation Public Affairs Officer. And right now, I'm also the acting N92 Morale Welfare Recreation Director. So we had a few questions that Public Affairs collected prior to this town hall. So we'll address some of those issues that were brought up. First, that towels that used to be distributed at the front desk at Bernie Gym. But prior to 2019, we did have a towel service at the gym. Around at that same time, the Navy came forward with a new program to discontinue towel service at all of its gyms worldwide. So we will continue with that. The towels will not be returning. If you please bring a towel to the gym, your own towel, and please wipe down equipment just to keep things sanitary. Another question came up about Latin Night at Club Alliance that we used to have. We're bringing that back next month. It'll happen on the 12th and the 19th. And the first session will be just open dancing, but the second session we'll have an instructor on hand that prior to the start of the event will provide lessons to anybody who cares to learn how to do salsa. So welcome that. We also received a couple of questions for Fleet and Family Services concerning Japanese language, so I'll have Shoei present that information.
Fleet Film Support Center. So there was a question about attending Japanese lessons with us. So currently we offer about 7 classes here in Yokosuka and 3 in Ikego to assist with learning the language and culture of Japan. The MWR Community Center also has senseis there that will teach you Japanese. And there are also college courses offered through our local colleges and universities. Additionally, there are classes offered by off-base community organizations through our Yokosuka City.
The next question we received had to do with CPR and first aid training.
So I'm happy to answer that too. We at Fleet and County do not offer CPR courses, but you can get them at the Red Cross. Typically, they will offer the certification, and you can give them a call about their next offering at DSN 243-7490.
And sir, I think you'll take the next question about EBT cards available for use at the Yokosuka Commissary.
Yeah, so the Conduct of All Commissaries, that is a Department of Defense program. So the Department of Defense program has not rolled out the equipment to implement EBT cards in Yokosuka. I'm only aware of one overseas location that allows them, and that's in Spain. We're looking into working with, the commissary to get that implemented, but right now there is no timeline for it.
Now, I'd like to ask Public Works to come up and present information concerning the HVAC system at Purdy Gym.
So Purdy Gym is under a $15 million contract to not only replace the old AC, but actually redesign and expand its capacity throughout the building. Design finishes this month, December. The contractor will mobilize in the spring, and we are working on a plan for next summer to implement temporary cooling. Thank you.
All right, the last few questions we had tonight concern bicycle safety as well as electric scooter and personal mobility devices.
So I'm Dean Lance, CFA Safety Director. There's currently enforcement program in place through security. This issue is not something that's excessive or extraneous. We're asking people to follow the rules, right? We're all civilians, we're military, we've all taken, know the code of conduct. The expectation is that you will wear a helmet, you'll ride your bike or your scooter safely, you'll not exceed the speed, you'll stop at the stop walks, you'll obey the traffic laws. That's the expectation. There's not going to be any specific or targeted enforcement on that because we currently have an enforcement program in place. And as for the last question involving electric scooters and that such, Misawa has them. However, and having multiple conversations with their safety department, they're getting ready to cancel that program because people are not following the rules of that. We have folks driving through the flight line on electric scooters, operating while they're intoxicated. That program is going away. That is also an air base. We are a Navy base. We follow Command and Navy Region Japan, and currently there is no plan to implement that program on this base, and until such time as that happens, there will not be allowed. There's no electric scooters, electric skateboards, the ripsticks, etc. They're not allowed. Thank you.
All right. Well, we do not have any questions from the audience tonight. So I'd like to invite you all next quarter to please come and personally attend the town hall. We'll be advertising on the CFA Facebook page. Really like to hear from you firsthand any questions you have concerning the installation. So look for that town hall in the month of March. That's it.